everybody, when they carry anti-social activity, the onus lies with the state governments and not with the prime minister, the central government, to act against them. And therefore, he requested to make a dossier and act on it. And therefore, the message is very loud and clear. This kind of anti-social activities cannot go around in India, because the Prime Minister believes in Sabka Saath, Sabka Vikas. And as far as RSS ideology is concerned, let me be very, very honest. That ideology is of what the Prime Minister says. We have to take the country together. That is Sabka Saath, Sabka Vikas. There can't be any two differences. There are incidents when people, you know, opposition are raising Dadri issue. Dadri is a law and order issue. It belongs to Samajwadi Party. If something has happened in Muzaffarnagar, it is Samajwadi Party. If something has happened in Bihar, it belongs to Lalu Prasad Yadav or Nitish Kumar. Why do you blame the Prime Minister for it? If something had happened in Mirchpur when the Congress was ruling, how can you blame BJP about it? So there, the message is, it's a law and order. You must take action. That's what the Prime Minister said. And that depends on the state government. And at the same time, he's saying if those who wish to take care of the cows, then Gau Seva means the first thing is the maximum number of cows dying is because of eating plastic. So Swachh Bharat, that is what the constructive steps the Prime Minister has initiated. Like Swachh Bharat, people don't understand the impact.
Now, even as the Prime Minister sent out a stern warning to the self-styled cow vigilantes, the opposition is now questioning the timing, saying the message means nothing if it is not followed up with action against these so-called Gau Rakshaks.
He had broken his deafening silence earlier. After all, a man called Muhammad Akhlaq was lynched in public by a mob of cow vigilantes or Gau Rakshaks almost a year ago in September 2015. If the Prime Minister had given the same message then, we would have not seen this menace of Gau Rakshaks spreading on a pan-Indian scale. But he chose to keep silent, although he makes a tweet on every other subject under the sun. Breaking his silence is welcome. The only question is, why so late?
Where was the Prime Minister when Akhlaq was lynched to death in Dadri? Why did the Prime Minister not speak out at that point in time? Because he wanted to use this particular incident to create polarization in Bihar. So therefore, the Prime Minister is extremely selective in his outrage. If the Prime Minister is serious, why does he not prevail upon the RSS to disband the Vishwa Hindu Parishad? Why does he not take action against the office bearers of the Bajrang Dal? So therefore, it is his ideological co-travellers who have been perpetrating this spectre of uncertainty and terror in the name of cow lumpenism across the country. Thereby, whatever the Prime Minister says today is absolutely humbug and it is completely sanctimonious.
तो मुजफ्फरनगर की घटना नहीं होती, ये उन्होंने क्या होता तो झारखंड में दो मुसलमान लड़कों को पेड़ों से नहीं लटकाया जाता, उधमपुर में घटना नहीं होती। लेकिन खाली ये कहना काफ़ी नहीं है, जिन लोगों ने ये घटनाएं की हैं वो जब तक सलाखों के पीछे नहीं होंगे तो कोई माने नहीं रखती है ये कहना। दो साल के बाद तो ये स्टेटमेंट आज दे रहे हैं, दो साल के बाद तो इन्होंने स्टेटमेंट देना चाहे था कि गौ रक्षा के नाम पर जिन्होंने कत्ल किया है, जिन्होंने लोगों को तंग किया है, मारा है, उनके खिलाफ कार्रवाई की है और इतने को उनको इतनी इतनी सज़ा जेल में है, तिहार में इतने ने हैं।
He gets targeted. I am very surprised because I thought he is accustomed to targeting other people. Even when he travels abroad, he's targeting India's other leaders, not just of the present generation, but of several past generations. And he's now saying that he gets targeted. If he doesn't centralize his operations and he allows decentralization to happen, which is good for any democracy, he will not get targeted. I mean, that's quite simple. I think he wants to be targeted when it comes to taking credits, but he doesn't want to be targeted when it comes to getting discredit. Well, it's his decision, frankly.
Very welcome statement, I must say, but this statement, I'm afraid, should have come much earlier. This statement and instruction should have come at Dadri's incident itself when it began. A clerk lost his life, thereafter so many repercussions took place, then in Una, and then in various places. We have been seeing all throughout the country, from particularly Madhya Pradesh, Gujarat, Rajasthan, even Maharashtra, they're all states ruled by Bharatiya Janata Party. We have seen that all these right-wing people have been talking rubbish.
Whatever happens in the country, it is obvious people will question the Prime Minister. It is not that people are not matured enough what to question, what not to question. But there are issues on which people expect PM to speak. For instance, the increasing atrocities on Dalits. Increasing crimes committed against Dalits, particularly in his own state of Gujarat. Why PM has not opened his mouth? Why PM has not uttered a single word on the atrocities committed against Dalits in the state of Gujarat? And if there are attacks on Muslims, definitely people will question the Prime Minister.